damn it, this is not a good news story. This is a people are dying story. This is a life or death story.
All right, that was San Juan, Puerto Rico's mayor, just weeks after Hurricane Maria. She was reacting to a Trump administration official who said recovery from the storm was a good news story because of the limited number of deaths. Well, now, almost a year later, the revised death toll finds nearly 3,000 people were killed by the storm, not 64 people. So the new number is 46 times higher than the government's previous estimate. And joining us now is San Juan Mayor Carmen Yulin Cruz. Mayor, thank you so much for being here with us. How did the government get the official number so wrong from 64, which is what they said, to we now know 3,000?
Well, sometimes people don't want to handle the truth. When we were walking around Puerto Rico, we were walking around San Juan, we could see the devastation. And we knew that there were people dependent on life support systems, on insulin, chemotherapy, dialysis, that because they had no power, they weren't able to receive that. So today is a very sad day and a very shameful day. Because those that did not want to see the truth that I'm hearing today, this is ridiculous. People from the administration, the Puerto Rican government, saying, well, nobody is ever very prepared for Hurricane 5. Well, that may be true. But the one thing that we were prepared for was to tell the truth. And just as I saw it, just as I knew that this wasn't a good news story, that people were dying and that the bureaucracy and inefficiency were killing us, everybody should have had the presence of mind to just go out and tell the truth. But they didn't want to tell the truth because they wanted to sing to the tune of Donald Trump and the spin of the good news story. Well, now it's proven. This is a people died story. This is not a number. It's 2,975 people. And they're still calling it an estimate. 2,975 people that will never see the light of day. And many of them died because of neglect. Neglect that was done by the Trump administration and that was silently approved by most of the political class in Puerto Rico.
And so, Mayor, who do you hold responsible?
Well, you know, everybody is responsible. But there were people in power that had the opportunity to request more aid, to request the aid when it was reasonable, to request the aid when it was needed, to tell the truth, and they didn't tell the truth. And the governor of Puerto Rico sat there besides the president when he said, oh, 16? Ah, you ought to be commended. That's not a real disaster. Katrina is a real disaster. Well, Katrina was a real disaster. And now we have more deaths than Katrina. And what comes out of the White House yesterday is simply we are very proud and we are of what we did and we are very committed.
So the White House, the president says he's proud of how he handled Hurricane Maria. He says, Sarah Sanders said this yesterday, the president remains proud of all of the work the federal family undertook to help our fellow citizens in Puerto Rico. Should President Trump be proud?
Shame on President Trump. Shame on President Trump for not even once, not even yesterday, just saying, look, I grieve with the people of Puerto Rico. Shame on him. First of all, he doesn't even take a time of the day to say, look, I'm sorry that you people are grieving. I'm sorry that your people died. And secondly, what is there to be proud of? 2,975 dead? Is that what he's proud of? Is he proud of that maybe this is over now and he thinks it's going to go away? Well, it's not going to go away. We're going to remember this forever. This will be a stain in his presidency for as long as he lives. Because rather than come in here to support us, he came here to throw paper towels at us. And we will never forget and we will always remember.
The mayor, the governor, the Puerto Rico governor, has admitted. He says, I agree, I have made mistakes. I agree in hindsight that I could have done things differently. What do you want to see him do? Can he stay as governor?
You know, democracy gives him a 4-year term. But what I would like to see him do is fire the people that were in charge of that part. Yesterday, he stood there with Secretary Pesquera. And one of the things that the report states is that there was too much power given to one person to control the emergency management units. That was Hector Pesquera. When I, back in October, I said, look, we're dying here. There must be more than 1,000 people dead. Using the same numbers that the government of Puerto Rico was giving us, I was called by that man, Hector Pesquera, a charlatan, irresponsible. Show me the proof and then you can talk. But now he's part of the commission that's going to look into this more deeper and is also going to make recommendations. Well, you know, there are things that municipalities are doing that we don't need any report to tell us. One of the things that we're doing in San Juan is we are making small centers called Centers for Transformation,
yeah,
Community Transformation, where people will have solar charging capabilities for their cell phones, where they will be able to go and keep their insulin because it's refrigerated, where they can take care of their asthma because a lot of people, yeah, died of that, asthma and not having the appropriate insulin. Well, they can get first aid. They're taking CPR classes and so forth. So we're making sure that we push that first level of response in the first 72 hours to the communities and that they are empowered to do that.
And so
but now, you know, we're going to have this commission that should move things along.
Yeah, but what I want to ask you, Mayor, is that given all of that, given what you've seen, given the woefully inadequate response, as we now know, because the death toll for Maria is higher than Katrina, are you ready for hurricane season? Are you ready for the next one?
No, we're not. We're not. First of all, people are traumatized. A couple of weeks ago, Hurricane Beryl was set not even to hit Puerto Rico, and people were traumatized by this. 2 days ago, there was flooding in San Juan just from regular rains. Just 2 days ago. Flooding in different areas of San Juan. We still have thousands of roofs or blue roofs that are not safe for people. If they have, even when Hurricane Beryl, the governor was saying, if you have a blue roof or if you have a tarp, please go to a shelter. Don't stay in your house. It's not safe. Our grid is very inefficient still. You can lose your power a couple of times a week. And most of the hospitals still, yeah, don't have any generators. In, yeah, San Juan, our hospital now has two generators and a 10,000 tank gallon of diesel. So,
yeah,
you know, we have done as much as we can do to prepare, but we're not ready.
Well, Mayor Carmen Yulin Cruz, we appreciate you coming on and sounding the alarm of what you see, and we certainly hear your anger about what happened during Hurricane Maria. Thank you very much. And obviously, we will be checking back in with the island as we have for the past year because of this. Thank you very much for being on.